levels of paras, from juvenile to the senior paras. There are 37 paras that are practicing here, and they're learning skating skills to help to develop them in their future competition seasons.
I'm Austin Hale. I moved to Fort Wayne 2.5 years ago with my coaches to pursue my skating career. I've been doing paras for 2 years now. I've been skating for a little over 8 years.
The difference between pair skating and singles is that in pairs, you have to actually try to match your partner and try to feel the movements that he's doing. You can't just go off on your own.
Today is a pair camp. We're basically just doing multiple on-ice and off-ice sessions with national skaters and Olympians.
I'm Tanith Belvin, Olympic silver medalist in ice dancing.
Massimo Scali, Olympic competitor for Italy.
So we are here at the National Pairs Camp, and essentially our role is to help the pair skaters develop their skating skills and help them with some of the partnering and transition holds that we as ice dancers incorporate into our everyday training.
Yeah, it's a great. We were working together and competing together for many years, so it's a pleasure to bring our knowledge back on the ice for these kids.
Pair skating is a small community and a very unique community because it combines the male and the female skater. It takes a lot of practice and in order to get the two to skate as one, which is the goal. And I think the beautiful part of it is in figure skating in general is the speed across the ice, and in pair skating, skating in general, that it combines the artistry and athleticism and musicality, and the skaters have to perform these very challenging skills and still have a smile on their face and perform, and if they fall down, they bounce up and make the audience forget that it even happens.
Pair partners, so I don't really have anything to compare her to, but basically when we first paired up, our timing was together and everything, we were just instantly in sync.
Matched up.